Good morning to all the cool kids out there. Thank you guys so much for joining me today. I am going to be sewing on these junk journal pages. I pretty much have the signature all picked out, cut to size, and everything ready to be sewn in. There are a couple steps that I need to do before that. This is going to be the inside of the journal right here. And I do want to thank you guys so much for joining me at this new time that I'm going to be going live from now on. for the foreseeable future at 7 a.m. Oh my God. 7 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. Hello, Kelly. Welcome. Sorry to go live a little bit late. I made some last minute decisions to make myself some coffee and a little bit of breakfast. So I do want to say thank you guys so much for joining me this morning. We need to get this signature put together and put into this junk journal right here. As you guys know, I am making about 20 junk journals, so you can imagine I'm a little bit I'm a little bit busy with junk journals right now. So let me get a piece of chipboard, which is what I like to use with these junk journals. One moment, I need to cut this down to the size of the journal. That's normally what I like to do. Let me see. And I'll tell you why, just because it makes it easier to like lay down the signature for me. So that's why I do this. And I just cut it down exactly to the size of the journal, of this basically one of these covers. So I should have done this before, but I'm not a morning person. I am not a morning person, and I'm still trying to learn how to go to bed early. Still a new thing for me, but I'm going to get to it. I'm going to do it. Hello, Zany. Hi, Crafty Reseller. Hello, Trudy. Hi, I Plan to Create. Carrie Ann, Don, Giselle. Hi, hi, you guys. Welcome. Welcome, welcome back to my channel. I was like obsessed. I found this new show that I like. It's a new show but on an old channel, and the person's channel is This Is Damn Bell. And I liked his channel originally because he did he would go through malls. I don't know why I would like to watch this show, but he would go through like malls. And like they were all dead or they were closed now. So he would walk, he started walking through malls and like abandoned places and like telling you the history of them and everything. And now he has a new channel. What I'm doing right here is separating the pages into like line pages, book pages, ephemera. Anyways, so he has this new channel or this new like kind of thing he's doing on his channel. Where he goes around to motel rooms, like dirty motel rooms. And hilarity ensues, of course. It's too funny. I might have to take out some of these pages. It might be too many. I don't think I can do two signatures in here, and this seems like a lot of pages. I'll have to figure that out in 1 second. Here's scrapbook paper, and these are bags. And this is lined paper, and I'll just put this over here in ephemera. So, let me see how many pages we have. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, we have way too many. I only put 15 per signature, and this is one signature. So, I need to put it down. So, anyway, so... his channel, like, it's about, they go around to dirty motel rooms, and they just, like, film it. It's too funny, though. They'll show you, like, the dirty pillowcases. I already have, like, a huge fear of hotels. If I don't know anybody, I don't go there. I don't like hotels. I don't deal with them. I can't. I just can't. So I just, this channel is so funny. Okay, so what I'm doing is I'm separating. Sorry, I'm telling you about that episode. So what I'm doing is I'm separating everything. I already took out basically half the stuff I planned to put in there. It's just too many pages. This journal is only good for one signature, which should be about 15 pages for me because of my sewing machine and everything. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What do I mean by signature? Signature is when you gather up pages. Like this book right here, this is one signature. So that means there's only one gathered up bunch of papers, right? So this is about 15 pages right here, maybe a little bit more. But you see that is one signature. There are books with more than one signature. For example, this one. This one has two signatures, so you can see the two like individual booklets right there. That's two. Hi, Kate, and then this is one. The one fat one, but it's one right here. You can see the difference right there between two and one signature. Okay, good morning, everybody. Good morning. We are here. I am awake, amazingly. My mom's going to be shocked to hear the new time. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. Okay. I'm overdoing it here. And I only put 15 pages because I like to decorate every single page. And they get really bulky if I do more than 15, 16, 18 pages. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. And again, they get really, really bulky if I add way too many pages. Of course, I always try to add too many pages, as I am doing right now. Okay, so final signature, we'll have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Might be 18. I might have missed one. Okay, so that's enough. That's like the most. So each signature is an individual booklet. Usually is 15 pages. Correct, Trudy. That is correct. That is correct. Okay, so here we have all the types of papers that I'm going to be using in the signature, which is ephemera that I've printed out. Well, this one's not really ephemera, but ephemera that I've printed out. It has lined paper on the inside. It's double-sided printed. So we have that. These are from my shop. And then we have book paper and this time card. And I have about three pages in each, almost, three, four. Lined paper on the other side. So now they're pockets on both sides. Three pages of printed journal pages of my own design that are in my store that I printed on the back of here also. Awesome, Elaine. You are going to love it, trust me. I printed on the back of scrapbook paper because I love, love, love just to do that, just to add some interest on the inside. And this is like that thin scrapbook paper. It's not cardstock. Okay, and here is the scrapbook paper that I'm going to be using that is coffee dyed, but it really only shows on the inside. But I also like to do that. This is some old scrapbook paper from my stash. I don't even like it, but they work in junk journals, so I'm starting to slowly get rid of it. Hi, Kat. Good morning. So let's get this signature put together. Let me get a little dunk of my coffee and my little sandwich here. Give me some energy. I'm going to become a morning person. It's going to take me some time. Okay. So I kind of like to alternate so that way I don't get too many line pages or anything like that. Kate says, do you use a silhouette or scan and cut to cut out your mystery box items? I use a scan and cut. Scan and cut is my favorite. Oh my gosh, I just saw Irina. Hi, Irina. My eyes don't work right now very well. They're still crusty. I'm just kidding. They're not crusty. Just getting my little cup of coffee here. Okay. So, like I said, I like to go around and kind of grab one page from the stash. In the very middle, though, I like to put one page that the inside is not so dark, like not a dark paper. And then I like to trace a line here in the middle. So that way when I'm sewing, I know where I'm going. Because I've done this kind of blindly. And it makes it so much harder. And would a Cricut work kind of like a scan and cut? I don't know where they are with the scanning with the Cricuts right now. So to be honest with you, I don't know like what their newest features are. I used to use a Cricut a long time ago, back when it was, you know, just cut the images off the cartridges. So I have no idea where they are in their technology, but I think I've heard something about the Cricut does something like that. And also the Silhouette also does something like it, but there's like a few extra steps. So if you can look it up on Google or on YouTube, I honestly have not kept up with what Cricut has been up to. So this is going to be, and I apologize about that. I should probably look it up because I have been asked. So it wouldn't hurt for me to know the difference too. Okay, so like I said, I cut this piece of chipboard, which is just a cereal box, basically almost to the size of the cover. It's a little bit smaller. It's actually cut out to the size of the inside cover, which is going to be this right here. So it's cut to this size right here because this is what it has to be centered on. So I do this. This is, I've made this live also, fabric, heat and bond, and packing paper. Same strategy that I used to actually make this journal cover right here if you haven't been keeping up or if you're new. And right here, what we're going to do is we are actually going to sew our signature onto this very cover here on the inside. I have already scored it in the very middle, which is where our signature is going to sit. So everything's going to sit right here while I sew this, and then we're going to glue this onto the cover right here. We got a couple steps to go, but for that is a general idea of what we are going to do this morning with this book right here. So we got our chipboard piece, which is not going to end up in the journal at all. It's just so that I can position my pages correctly. And right now it doesn't actually really matter because I'm just trying to get the order of the pages that I'm going to use. Then let's use, I kind of like to use like a big piece of paper and then a small one. And then we'll go back to a big piece of paper, kind of layer it in a bit, in a sense. Let's do that. I'm going to slide this one up here. And also, I like to keep all the pages up tight here. Right now, like I said, it doesn't matter because I'm just trying to get the order of it. I think I'm going to do this. I pushed one page up and one page down to kind of give you a little bit of an overview of all the papers, which is what I really, really like. And then we'll go in with a piece of scrapbook paper. I normally go in order to not kind of mess it up, but I chose not to, I guess, in this sense. Here is a like baked good bag right here. Gonna grab some ephemera. And we're going back in with, I'm gonna use this one right here. And then we're gonna go in with lined paper. We're going to go in with a journal page. Is it buffering for anybody else or is everybody else here? Let's see. Who's here with me? Put another scrapbook page. I'll use this airplane one. only because on the inside I kind of use this orangey one, so I want to use this black one just to kind of change it up. Then we will pick out, oh, I like this right here. This is a nice book page. Hello, Jill. Good morning. I'm here bright and early. This is the time I'm going to start going live, everybody, so I hope it's okay for everybody. Mm-hmm. And we'll have this right here. Put another ephemera page. Okay, let's go in with another one of these journal pages. I'm trying to figure out the order now so that I can figure out where I'm going to put lace, because that's our next step, is to add some pretty, pretty lace. So I kind of got to decide where everything's going to go. Okay, so this is going to be our signature. Ooh, I'm glad that turned out well. And I really don't freak out about it not being even. Some people like want it to be even. You could get your cutter out right now and cut it out, but it doesn't bother me in particular. Some people like it to be even. I totally get that. So I'm taking out my sewing machine. And actually, I need to do up some of the bobbins. So sorry for not having that done. Again, I'm going to become a morning person. It's just going to take me a little while. It's just going to take me just a little while. Okay, let's get the spool on here. One moment. I'm just getting this prepped up here. If you want to see what I'm doing. I'm trying to do the little bobbins. Oh my gosh. Okay. One moment while I do this and take a sip of coffee. Oh, it's not even on. Oh my gosh. It's now on. Okay, good. Hi, Gigi. I just saw you. And Kate, yes, I do. I do. I will be doing that in a couple other journals. I wanted to do something simple today. So I just chose the one signature to do right now this morning. But I do have plenty of two signatures that I'm going to do the same way. The same exact way. It's just a little bit more complicated. But yeah, two signatures is the most I'll do, because like I said, I like to decorate every single page of the journals. I don't think I've said that today, but I like to decorate every single page of the journals. And if I do more than two signatures, I don't know why it feels like forever to decorate. So I've decided to do one or two signatures and that's it. I've done it before, 3-4 signatures, and I get like a little discouraged because it feels like forever. Like I've literally done it. Like if I hadn't literally done it, I wouldn't be able to say that. But and I get it. The look is cool, but and I just can't. I just can't. Drives me a little crazy. 10 signature book. I'm telling you, Dana, that's a big book, man. That sounds pretty big. But you really want to see a lot of ephemera for one book. Yeah. I have a lot of ephemera. Okay. So this is a signature. And I like to decide on the order so that I can decide where I'm going to... Oh, this is the wrong bag. Is this the right bag? No, this is the wrong bag. I have scraps of fabric that I want to use. Is that the right bag? It doesn't feel like the right bag. Let me see. Oh, it is. Okay, so I have made strips. Oh my gosh. I have made strips of fabric. Different kinds of fabric that I have. And these are all bed sheets, of course, if you guys have been. How many pages in the signature? There's 18 pages folded in half. I went a little overboard. And these are the strips that I want to sew onto the sides of the pages here. So I'm going to alternate different fabric scraps in the pages. Not every page gets one. But like every three pages, I'll put down a strip. So let me get this all put aside so I can see which strips I'm gonna do. I don't like them to be too wide because then they'll take up the whole page. And the strips are maybe about 1 inch wide. Maybe a little bit smaller. You could use lace for this also, but I like to use fabric. Oh, I'm happy you're here, Dana. Thanks for watching. You're sweet. Here's another strip. I'm just pulling out random strips. They don't have to coordinate. I'm not worried about like a color palette. Like, certain journals call for that, but not these. I like to not be so stressed out about stuff like that. Here's a pink one. Here's another one of these. Oh, thank you, Trudy. Oh, hi, April. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. I'm up. I can't believe it. I'm up. I'm up. Blue dots. Let's see. Oh, here's another one. Just trying to get all sorts of strips. This one might be a little bit too wide. Okay, I said I wasn't gonna, and now I have pulled out every single little piece of fabric that was in my bag. Oh my god. Okay, that one. And I've actually used up a lot of these scraps already, but I keep making more. Because these are bed sheets, so y'all know I have a lot of fabric to go. So it's okay. It's gonna be a little skinnier. Aw, thank you. Oh, yeah, you had to watch your granddaughter. That'll make you switch, all right. Okay, I think I have more than enough, but let me keep looking, though. Let's see. It's actually cold today. Oh my gosh. I turned on my heater. I do not like this whole change of weather. It's the worst because I can't make up its mind. I don't want it to be summer. I really don't. I really do not want it to be summer. I don't really get a choice though. But here we are dealing with it, right? We're all dealing with it. Okay. Let's see. Okay. We're going to have to do like scraps of scraps on other pages. On other books, I mean. Because I have some small scraps, and usually, sometimes I like to put a couple pieces of these small ones. Okay, so that should be enough. So, somehow pile every, this is like the clown car right here. It's somehow they all fit back in there if I just smush them right. Smush them the right way. Okay. There we go. So now, oh, there's my mouse pad. Okay, so now we have the scrap pieces here picked out. And like I said, I like to sew them on the edge here. And I'll generally pick every two or three pages, depending how I'm feeling. Probably it'll be every two pages on here because, I don't know, I want to put a lot of them, I guess. No, we'll do every three. And actually, let me move this around. This is a timer and you can move things around. It's your last time to do this. Actually, no, I don't want to cover up this hot man right there. I don't want to cover up the goods. Let's put this one right here. Trying to get something like small in between the other pages. I don't know why I just changed my mind, but I did. Let's see. It's okay. Now is the chance to change your mind before it's permanent. Let's see. Where would this go? Right here. Let's put it right here. Instead. Yeah. Okay. I like that. That's good. Okay, now. Let's get one page out the signature. Put the rest aside. It's raining there. Oh my gosh. Here is my sewing machine, in case you guys want to know. It is the Brothers Project Runway Limited Edition CE1125 PRW. I know that now. I know that number by heart now. Oh my gosh. Okay, so I got my sewing machine. I have to change out the bobbin. Now I have several. I'm ready. There's a couple of junk journals that use this thread, and I haven't finished them because I've been too lazy to reload the machine. Okay, let's get it in here. Okay, right there. Okay, and then the bobbin. And like I said, you could totally use lace here. But I have so much scrap fabric that I might as well use it up. And this is the perfect project to do so. So I am going to start sewing the scraps on here. It doesn't really matter what order they're in. Not to me, anyways. I cut it about the size of the page. And I'm going to use a zigzag stitch with this. And I want to make sure it's really wide. And a little bit long. Just a little bit. The length is set on 2 and the width is set on 7. On stitch number 4, if you have the same machine. I know a couple of people do, and they like to know what setting I use. So I'm just going to sew down the middle of the strip here, and I don't want to pull on it. I just want to make sure it's in place. And I don't backstitch. I know it freaks some people out. Yeah, I don't do backstitching. I don't worry about it. Okay. Is this big enough for this other side? Ooh, just barely. Not really. Let's put another piece. It's cool if it matches, but it's fine. It's fine if it doesn't, too. And this one's a little bit crinkly, but that's okay. It will kind of flatten out here. I wanted to check the mail before I went live, Irina. I was like, maybe, but it's too freaking cold out there. It's too cold out there. Right now at 7 in the morning, it was too cold. So I'll have to wait till noon, but I did go Monday and it wasn't there, which is weird, but I don't know. I don't know. And since this one's a little wide, I think I'll do a straight stitch down here also, just to be safe. My little foot pedal by my foot. Just because it's a little wide, so I might actually want to do a couple stitches. I normally don't, but we should be a little special. I'm going to try and treat these journals a little bit more special. Hi, Sandra. Okay, let's do straight stitch here. I'll have to check today during the afternoon when it's not that cold. It's just so windy right now. Oh, it's actually cold today. Like, it's been really hot the last couple days. But it was actually cold today, this morning. I have a sweater on right now and sweatpants. I slept with sweatpants and a sweater, so it was a little cold. But not enough to turn on the heat last night, though. So here's our first page that we did the little stitching on. So let's move on to the next page that we're going to do it on. And I think I'm going to go every two, I suppose. So why not? And then I'm left with even smaller scraps. And these scraps I end up, some journals I kind of end up like Frankensteining, you know, it. Because I'm left with little tiny scraps of everything sometimes. Let's see if I can cut this in half, maybe, or maybe a little bit less than half. Ugh. Ugh. Gotta be so strong for these sometimes. Oh my goodness. This is a long strip. Cut off some of the white space. And again, I'm not trying to coordinate with anything. So, I'm not really worried about it not matching exactly. It's fine. It's a junk journal. I ain't worried about it. Let's cut this spot right here. That way you get some nice little bit of the design. Of course, that'll be for another page. Try to get that little funky look where it doesn't all match, which is fine. That's what I started with. Okay, so let's sew this now. And, okay, here we go, over here. So let's do zigzag stitch. Down the middle. Let's see here. Okay. Me too, Maryvale. Me too. And then we'll do a straight stitch. Just to make it lay down even flatter. I'm doing this on both sides of the zigzag stitch. Just to add a little bit of interest, you know, make a little bit of couture. Just kidding. Oh my god, coffee. Okay. So now on this side, zigzag going. Yes, right there. Down the middle. Oh, yeah. I found out last night that one of my aunts passed away, so I'm really sad about that. I probably will have to go to her funeral in the next couple weeks. She is really sweet. She was born a little person, so she, I don't know what she had, but she was like basically like childlike her whole life. She was so funny. Like, anytime you'd go over to her house, she would go, pow. She'd be like, pow, pow. Like, she'd make a little gut. She'd be like, pow, pow, you're dead. And you had to act like you were dead. She's so funny. And then, like, anytime we had a party, she was always wanting to dance. And she'd grab the freaking microphone out of the singer's hand and she'd start to sing and oh my god. She was so fun. And basically, you know, because she was a little person ever since I was a kid, it basically, you know, made me think about her every time I saw somebody else with disabilities, and it made me like second guess, you know, making fun of them and stuff. So that's why she was kind of like important to me. Yeah. Good memories, of course. I have great memories of her. She was a great... to me, she was my aunt. She always called me cousin. You know, because like I said, she was like childlike and I was a child, so she figured I was her cousin. She's so cute. So she's going to be very, very missed. So gonna have to get together with family and say goodbye. But yeah, she was a great person. Taught me a lot. Okay, so let's add this strip of fabric here. Life, you know, you guys, just life. It happens. And this one I don't have to do two stitches on. I'll just do one. We're still going to do the widest. Let's see here. So I always have happy memories of her. Happy memories, yeah. I'm not, I mean, I'm sad that she's gone, and it was a very, it was a shock, you know? But she had a good life, and she was well-loved and well-treated, and she was always at home with her mom, you know? So, that's the best life for her. That she led the best life that she, could have had. So, for that, I'm thankful and happy. Here. Some fabric scraps I really need to get rid of because they're too small. They're just way too small. And let's get a zigzag stitch on here. Yeah, she really did, Dana. She really did. Like I said, growing up with her as, you know, a special needs person, as a child, like I said, it really made me think twice when I would, like, look at somebody differently, or maybe it made me stop from, like, thinking about making fun of somebody. It's my aunt's special, you know? So, yeah. Let's get these little edges here cut off. And then we're going to do a straight stitch here. This one does need a little bit of a straight stitch. Thank you, everybody. Thank you for your kind words. Okay, so we got those done. Let's move on to the next couple pages. I guess it could have used this straight stitch. Okay, okay, I'll put the straight stitch on here. Okay, okay. Let's do this one right here. Another straight stitch. And I cut off the strings as I go along. They bug me. I don't like them to be too long. Okay, so there's that page. Now to this one. Let's put this dotted one. Well, not. Let's do this floral one on here. And this is just one of those legal yellow pads, you know, the old school ones. Just the real old school ones. Let's get this fabric off of here. Coffee refill time, yeah, it's gonna have to be that time for me too. No, I still have some left. I'm not a big coffee drinker, but sometimes if I have to be up this early, it really makes me want coffee. Or, because I'm not hungry, but, you know, I need something to fill my stomach. So that helps. And then also peer pressure sometimes when everybody else is having coffee. I'm like, all right, I don't want to be the odd one out. But, like, me on a regular basis, I could go months without coffee, because like some people I always say this, like some people they use it to wake up, you know, or they'll have like an energy bowl or something to wake up, and I'm just like, you know what, if you're tired, like, man, just take a nap, like why why are you trying to fight it, just take a nap. So that's what I do. If I'm tired, I'll just take a nap. Like, I'm not gonna try and fight to stay up. Okay, so that looks really pretty with the blue thread. I'm happy I picked that. I need a fresh cup. I usually have coffee after at first two, then a bit food later. I don't need coffee. You know what I like in the morning? I like fruit. Fruit in the morning. That'll be my coffee. That wakes me up. Like a banana shake or something. That wakes me up. Like I said, I'm not usually hungry in the very beginning of the morning. Like right now, it's too early for me to be hungry. But I needed something because I knew in a little bit I was going to be hungry. Coffee's getting cold. Oh no. Oh, no. Okay. Yes, the blue is pretty. It has a lot of white space, but it does have its nice design, you know? It does look pretty good. And let's do a straight stitch over here. That doesn't matter, does it? With the straight stitch. Doesn't matter how wide it is. Fruit is your nighttime snack. Nighttime. Fruit is all day. All day. All day. I love fruit any time of the day. It does not matter. Fruit. Otherwise, I want actual sugar. Fruit calms my sugar cravings down. Okay, so here's this right here, this page, done. Doesn't take up too much of the page, but kind of does. Okay, let's do the lace on this one. Is that plain upside down? Yeah, that plane's upside down, I think. Gosh darn it, I can't tell the way these planes go. I really can't tell. I think it's like this. That plane looks the same way either way. You gotta get your machine looked at. Well, Tuna, your oldest daughter, gave me her machine, plus a neighbor moved out and left her machine over a year ago. No cord. So I'm not sure if it even works. Usually they all use the same cord. Usually. It's that one, like, generic cord that, like, even powers your printer. It looks the same. Maybe. I guess it could be a little different. Have you tried to look up the model? Plus the cord. Like, just look up the model name plus, like, cord. Power cord. That's what I would do. Two. And the widest zigzag here. Okay. Oh man, sewing machines, they might as well be like cars. I don't know, I feel like they're so complicated. So complicated. It's fun while they work, but if they don't work, oh my gosh. Pain in the neck. In the neck. That's pretty. Ooh, I like that contrast with the blue and then the gray. I love it. Hi, Gina. What's up? How's Hawaii? Probably awesome. Probably the best place ever. I'm jealous. I want to be in Hawaii. Let's see, is this crooked? I think this is crooked. Oh my goodness. Yeah, but Joanne's across our main street that sends them out once a month, estimates, etc. Pretty sure a T-note is needed on one. Let's see. I like Joanne's. The way they help you with your sewing machine. They helped my friend one time with his sewing machine. I thought that was cool. I did a straight stitch instead of a zigzag. Oh, no. Oh, man. Oh man, I should have done a zigzag. Let me do a zigzag instead on top. I don't care. I don't care. Oh well, we did a zigzag and straight stitch. That actually looks kind of cute. I'm not mad at it. Dirty. Well, for mine, I feel like I could use my scanning cut power cord on it. It's like a pretty common cord for mine anyways. Oh, it's supposed to be straight stitch. Just needs a little bit of extra stitching to hold it down. Yeah, look it up on Amazon. Amazon. Okay. Yeah, I really like that gray with the colors. I like it. I'm into it. I'm gonna do it on this one. I don't care. Wait, no. Okay. We'll just do. This paper is a little thin, should I say? It's a little thin. Okay, let's do it anyways. But to kind of secure the ends, I'm going to use some washi tape so that it doesn't damage the actual paper too much. Ooh, that's not on the edge though. Oops. Okay, fine. It's not going to be exactly on the edge. And you know what? I'm okay with it. I think that's fine. Just put a little bit of washi tape so that way I can sew through it because it's really, really thin actually. I don't even know if this paper will actually show. Probably because it's black. It'll probably show. But that's okay too. That's okay. Okay. Let's get this off here, right here. Okay. Just a little bit of washi tape. Not too much. This is gonna go here. Oh, it's gotta end start right here. Whoops. Okay, I used a cell phone wire on my Kindle once because it looked like the same and it ruined my Kindle. Oh no! Oh no, that's terrible. I usually use the same cord it comes with myself. The only time I haven't is with my camera. I think I've used other chargers on it. It just charges very slowly compared to its original charger. But I've never done it with actual machine, I guess. It might have gunked up my needle now that I think about it. Maybe I shouldn't have used washi tape. Maybe I won't use washi tape for the next time. I just thought about it. It's glue. It's not like it's dried up glue either. Okay, next time. too thin, just slightly. Okay. Can barely see it, but that's okay. I'll live. I'll be okay. Bye-bye, Kate. I just noticed I need to look at the chat a little bit more. Sorry. My hair trying to keep my eye on this needle. Oh, my gosh. Okay. So, moving it along here. This goes here. And we're almost done. Woohoo! With all the sewing on the inside of the journal, anyways. Let's see what we have. Okay, this will work for this side. Then on the other side. Okay, we'll use this right here. Too many strings. Okay. We're gonna go with the zigzag stitch. Strawberries and cherries are your first choice. That sounds good. You love pineapple. I love pineapple on my pizza. Oh my God. I love pineapple too, but pineapple is good. I like pineapple because it's the only fruit, like, at the stores that I trust to sit there. Because pineapple kind of just gets better and better, like, every day as it goes by after you cut it. Because, like, I'm afraid to buy, like, pre-cut apples or pre-cut fruits at the store because they go bad so easily. Like, I've had green melon that does not taste good or watermelon that does not taste good. But pineapple, like I said, it just gets better as it sits there. Let's do zigzag here. Zigzag. Okay. door. Welcome. And for peaches, if you ever get a chance to enjoy a Red Haven peach, it's the best tasting and juiciest peach I've ever had. That sounds good. We're going to do a straight stitch now. I like white peaches myself. It's my favorite white peaches. Or white nectarines. So good. Okay, so now we just have this inside one to do, and that'll be it for the inside stitching. And we can actually attach it to the signature. Only been quite a while. Let's see. Yeah, I kind of don't want to put any on the inside just because it's so pretty. I don't want to cover the words up. I really don't. Even though I have been on the other pages with no problem, here I don't want to. Okay, here's this little one. Ooh. Okay, here's this little one. This will work a little better. It'll just cover up the G. It'll only cover up the G. So let's see. Okay, so let's put this here. Yeah, it is expensive for fruit. It takes a lot of water and a lot of work. I can see why. I can see why it's expensive. Oh my gosh. Okay, so let's pick one more paper, or one more piece of scrap for the edge here. This edge. And I actually need to get a piece of scrap, like, wow. That was not enough scraps to cover it. Wait, there's this one. Okay, never mind. Okay. I can't wait to decorate. I have so many embellishments for these journals. Oh my gosh. So many. Oh no, my third came out. Okay, no. The number of embellishments I have for these journals is ridiculous. It's probably like 5 pounds of embellishments. I feel like it. I haven't weighed them, but it feels like it. Let's see what happened here. Come on, I'm almost done. Somehow my needle got all the way wrapped around. I don't know how this happened. Put the thread like wrapped around the needle? I don't even know how. Okay. Zigzag stitches on. Bye, Georgia. Have a good day. Okay, straight stitch. Okay. So we are, oh my God, all done with the sewing on the inside of these. Okay. Woo. My back hurt, you guys. My back. Okay, so that's all done now. So let's get them back in order. And hang on, I need some giant paper clips. And also, I don't know which one of these two I'll need. I can't remember which one I used. I have binder clips. And I also have giant paper clips. Which are gigantic paper clips. I love them. They just look funny. They make me laugh. Okay, so now we're going to get our signature together to actually sew it together. So this is when this chipboard piece actually matters. So again, I like to use a chipboard piece about the size of the page of the actual cover to keep the spine up tight against each other, all the pages, and also so that I can have it in the middle so that when I put it down on the cover... Oh, wait, which actually I need to do something to the cover before I sew it on there. Oh, my God. I forgot I need to do a zigzag stitch all around the cover. So, 1 second while I do that really fast. I almost forgot this step. I just don't want the fabric to fray, so I like to stitch around it. All this talk about fruit, I had to cut up apples and oranges. That sounds good, girl. Sounds good. Good choice. Good choice. Here. You clip your cardboard to top page so you can use that as your guide for something. No, I don't. Okay, so there we go. I had a sew around it. You probably can't even tell. Ooh, the sun's coming in. You could see it. That's funny. Okay, so back to what I was doing. Putting the pages where they go. This is kind of like your last chance to get them all facing the right way. Let's do this right here. Oh, this one was up. And this one was down. And then this page. Again, keeping it nice and tight up against the cards, against the chipboard. Part is like this is the like least favorite part of making a journal, and it doesn't even matter what kind of binding method I use. Like, binding a journal always makes me so nervous. I don't know how many times I've done this, but it still makes me nervous. It's still nerve-wracking to me. And this is the easiest method I've been able to find. I sew it with my sewing machine. Other people do pamphlet stitching or whatever works for you. But I do mine with my sewing machine, so you'll see what is going on. Okay, thank you, Laura, for letting me know. Okay, this right here. We're almost done with the signature. Again, just making sure it's tight up against the spine. It's not loose. Tight, 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 tight and right. Okay. And here we go. Now they're all good. So now I like to grab my, I guess I'll use a giant paper clip for now. Okay. So again, make sure it's tight against the spine. Okay. And then I'll put it in place. And like again, I fold this in half and then I know exactly where the middle is. And I can kind of center it along here. Okay. And then let me clip it to this page too so he doesn't get up, it doesn't move. Okay, it's good, it's good. That's where it should lay. Should be up a little bit higher though. Make your little adjustments. Okay, so now that is why I make the line down the middle so that way I can see what I'm sewing. So, is there a story behind your online name? I guess I've been using Tsunami Rose online since I was 13. It's been my username ever since I can remember. I actually borrowed the name from a friend in middle school. She actually came up with it, and I said, I'm going to use that on my AOL as my AOL screen name because she had another name. And I've kind of just been using Tsunami Rose ever since. She's still my friend on Facebook, so she knows. She must know. So that's it. That's the story. Okay. Again, if I do more than 15 pages, and I go slow just because I'm extra. But I can do just 15 to 18 pages is the most I should do. And then I should have backstitched it in the beginning. Oh well. This I do backstitch. Just a tiny bit. Okay. So that is our journal. Now we take this off. Gonna use another type of clip right now. It's pretty painless, but it still makes me nervous. Still makes me real nervous though. Gotta fold it. But it seems pretty good. So now, so here you could see where the middle was and where I actually ended up sewing. It's just a little off center, but that's okay. And then you clip these together because we need to glue them to the cover. So I actually learned this strategy from Zoe Tofield on YouTube, but she made her spine like this. Like she sewed her spine onto the fabric, but then she made the spine was only like this wide. And I was like, why don't you just make the whole thing out of fabric? So So that's how that ended up like that. Okay, so now we need to glue. Well, I love roses. So that's also why I was like, well, like I'm taking that name, yo. Like I'm friggin' taking it. I totally stole her name. I don't know. Maybe I'll send her a couple thousand in the mail one day. Be like, thanks, girl, for your contributions. I'm messed up, I know. I was a kid. I don't know. Okay. I need a sponge applicator. So give me 1 second. Let me go get that. Okay. Minor hand-sewn signatures. I have hand-sewn signatures as well. It's just my hands, like I said, I don't know what's wrong with my hands. I finally have insurance, so we're going to find out what is wrong with my hands. But I can't do a lot of things. My hands lose strength very, very fast. And so I have to do shortcuts like this. Do I not have an open glue? I thought this looked open. Let's see. What's up with these weirdos? Get a job, you guys. Get a job. Okay. Okay, the glue will come out. Yeah, I've done that too. I have a video where I did that. It really works if you're going to do it by hand. Graph paper. Yep. That's the secret. Graph paper. Okay, and I'm using Turbo Tacky Glue by Eileen's. That is my favorite glue. Do you ever find that the weight of the pages pull inside away from the cover? No. Nope. Okay, so right here, what this is the actual, you can't see it because it's white, but it's actually the other side of the heat and bond, and it's actually, I feel so wasteful throwing it away because it's plastic, and I love turtles, and I feel like a turtle's going to die if I throw plastic away, so I like to reuse it a couple times. So, like, in this instance, I like to use it to put glue on stuff. Because then at least I used it one more time. One-time use plastics are terrible, you guys. Just terrible for turtles. And I love turtles. Like, I don't know. I have this thing with turtles, like, you could hurt anything else and I'd be like, whatever. But if I see a turtle getting hurt, like, that's where I draw the line, you guys. No, you're not going to hurt this turtle. I messed up like that. Okay, so we got one half with glue on it. Get this out the way. And let me make sure, what's the front of the cover? Is that the front of the cover or is this the front of the cover? This. Okay, so now we try and center the signature. It's kind of hard to tell where the center is. Put the little jacket on. Try and make it kind of even. Okay. So that's nice and on now. That's good. This is my favorite one, though. I've used the Eileen Tacky Glue. Turbo Tacky Glue, though, is another situation. Turbo Tacky Glue. That's what I love. It's my new love. Where is my bone knife? Well, good thing I got a backup. I like to kind of make the crease in here where the signature folds. Oh, it's over here. Is this way off? Yeah, it's way off. Why is it so way off? That's weird. It's a little off the center. Is it really? Wow, it is. Huh, why is it so off-centered? I thought I sewed it in the right spot. Ooh, did I sew it in the wrong spot? Oh, I might have sewed it on the wrong spot. Gosh darn it, I sewed it on the wrong spot. So this one's a little... Gosh darn it. It happens, you guys. Things happen, and you gotta deal with it. Okay, so I screwed up. Did I? It doesn't feel like I did, but I did. Somehow, this cover is not centered. I'm trying to figure out what should I do. Should I leave it? This one's just imperfect. This one's just imperfect. I'm trying to see what should I do. What should I do? Should I let it dry? Yeah, let me see. Nah, you know what? I'm just going to deal with it. I'm just going to deal with it. I'm not going to worry about it too much. Can't get them all right. I'll try and figure something out. Still going to work with it. I'm still going to finish it. It's just not perfect. I think it's because something about the cover just did not come out right today. I'm still going to do it. I woke up early. I'm still going to put it on here. I don't care. I don't know. I got to figure out what I did wrong, though. That's the key. How did this not come out straight? Is it because it's just like placed wrong on the signature? It happens sometimes. This one's a mystery to me, though, because I did everything right. It's centered. It looks centered. It doesn't look off center. Maybe, what could have happened? I'm trying to figure it out myself. Get the glue out to the edge. Get it on the... on the sewing part. Let's see. It's even on here. Maybe it just needs to be pulled a little bit more to this side or something. Just a little bit. Let's see. Okay, that's better. Maybe it's just my eyesight that's crooked. Perhaps. Okay. I don't know. It looks fine now. I don't know what's wrong with me. Okay. So let's finish this before I go crazy. It looks good actually now. I don't know what happened. But it looks better. Okay. Let me get another piece of that heat and bond stuff. Is the perfect material for this. Just get it on the heat and bond and it's all good. It doesn't matter. Fold it and you keep using it. I love this stuff. This is almost like the craft mat. You can even wipe the heat and bond down with like a baby wipe and just keep reusing it. It's great. It's great for this type of mess here. Okay. Got the glue all over the place. Okay, so now we're going to flip it. Get this glue off my hands. Oh my gosh. Get the signature facing up. Yeah, that's more in the center than I thought it was going to be. That's great. Okay, so I do find that the signature starts to come off the paper, or it kind of starts to lift. So that's why I will leave this drying, like just like this. And also, there's one other precaution I do take, which is paper clips. One second, I'm trying to carve out this spine part right here. Okay, that looks good. Okay, so let me get my paper clips. So like I said, to let this signature dry, I will let it dry like this. It's something like sandwiched in between it like that. And then I always find that it does lift off of this part right here. This part right here tends to lift off. So what I like to do is I will paperclip it down just right here. This part right here tends to pop off. I don't know why. It's probably the weight of the signature, like somebody asked. So this right here will be weighed down or with the paperclip. See right there, it does lift off. Again, with the paperclip, it won't. And being supported by something on both sides, it won't. So that also helps with that part. I have to do two paper clips on both sides, but that's okay. Okay, there, and then one more paper clip over here. It's actually centered. I don't know why I thought it wasn't centered. It needed to be moved over to one side of the spine a bit. Okay, so that'll keep that part from getting off. And then, right here, another paper clip. And another paper clip right here. Come on, paper clips. Okay, so there we go. And then I'm going to let this dry, like I said, being supported by something on both sides like that, so that way it doesn't lift. And we just got to let this dry, and we're going to move on to making our other 19 junk journals. But for today, we're all done for today. I want to thank everybody so much for joining me today and for hanging out with me this morning, working on this junk journal with me. Thank you guys so much. I will be back tomorrow morning at 7 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, and we'll be working on another junk journal. So I want to thank everybody so much for hanging out with me. Thank you to Elaine. Thank you to Trudy. Thank you, Maryville. Thank you, Elaine. Thank you, Patricia. Thank you, Dana. Thank you, Laura. Everybody, so much. Thank you, guys. If you do get a chance to try out this glue, I really, really suggest that you do. This glue is awesome. I've used the regular tacky glue, and this is like so much better. Honestly, it's so much better. So thank you guys so much for hanging out with me, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. We'll probably be doing the same thing. So we'll hang out tomorrow. Peace out, you guys. Have a good day.